All right, Stephan, let's talk a little bit about hydroponics.
Well, I appreciate you having me on the show today.
Sure, sure.
Hydroponics is really kind of a new term that's kind of come up.
Okay.
But it's an old technology that's existed for actually centuries. But it's basically growing fruits and vegetables in water-based in a water-based system.
Okay.
Whether you have a soilless media or you just grow straight in water.
Okay.
But basically, hydroponics is having your root system in water, and you're providing those basic nutrients that the plants actually need to grow. It's a faster way to grow your items. It's very controllable. As long as you control the pH, you control your light, and you can actually have it in a smaller space, and you can actually grow those items that you want a little bit faster and more manageable.
Ah, sounds pretty good. You familiar with the hydroponic system, Mr. Dick?
I've seen a little bit of it. I've seen hydroponic tomatoes. I saw some hydroponic strawberries in a greenhouse one time, and it's always been very interesting.
Okay.
I mean, grow them in the middle of the winter.
Oh, absolutely. Hydroponics allows you to grow year-round as long as you have those conditions. You can grow outdoors, and you can also grow indoors. As long as you have those conditions, and you can control your conditions. Most of the high producers grow strawberries, and what they do is they elevate their strawberries, so that way they can actually produce more, harvest more, and then they have a consistent yield and can produce more during the year.
That's pretty, all right, okay. Now, what is aeroponics, though?
Aeroponics is similar to hydroponics,
okay.
But instead of actually having a pump system that continuously runs water, aeroponics has a timer where it mists the water onto the soil's roots, and then it cuts off.
Huh.
And so you're actually using a little bit less power, but you actually have the same growing power.
Wow. I've never heard of that.
Yeah, I've never heard of that either. Okay.
All right. Less water, too. Sure.
Yes, less water.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, what's going to be the pros and cons?
The pros are you can control your water, you can control your temperatures, you can control your lights. You're basically controlling the atmosphere. You don't have to deal with Mother Nature. The cons are you have to have a power source.
Okay.
And if you do not have power, you do not have anything growing once the roots get dry.
Right.
So you have to have your roots wetted all the time.
Right. Wow, how about that? Okay, now let's talk about, you said nutrient solution. So what are we talking about there?
Basically, it's a nutrient solution that's going to give your basic nutrients. You know, you need your nitrogen, your phosphorus, your potassium. But there's also 6 more basic ones and then 7 more additionals, the 13 that you need. So basically, you have a solution that provides the key nutrients that the plants need to grow. So you don't have to worry about if the soil's going to provide it for you because you're providing it for them because there is no soil. You're putting it in the water solution and the plants uptake it into its foliage.
Okay. So soilless media then.
Soilless media.
You said we don't need the soil, right?
Yeah.
So soilless
absolutely.
Media.
A lot of the medias that you use is really just a placeholder to keep the plants upright. So that way it has something stable while the roots are connected into the water, pulling up those nutrients to grow.
Well, how are these plants supported most of the time?
Most of the time you can use like a Rockwool where the roots just grow through it and it just absorbs. It's like a sponge.
Right.
That's how Rockwool is. Or you can have little beads that actually just lets the roots grow through, but it actually holds the plant in place.
Kind of like soil.
Kind of like soil.
How about that? Okay. Now, speaking of the seeds, now, are we doing that from seed or do they need to be, you know, transplants or
how
does that work?
It's better to actually do it from transplants.
Ah, from transplants.
Yeah.
Okay.
You start your plants off more so in like a Rockwool little tray. And then you get them going. Once you actually get your plants up to its first true leaf, then you can transplant them into the system.
Probably pretty easy to transplant too when you
grow absolutely.
Them in water.
Mm-hmm. Because most times if you have them in the Rockwool trays, you can just break things
up
into the cubes and put them into the cups.
Mm-hmm.
And then that way the roots are already going down to the moisture.
Ah, makes sense.
Pretty neat.
Yeah, that is pretty neat. Now, and you mentioned earlier about pH. You know, Mr. D and I talk a lot about pH.
So, oh, absolutely.
Yeah, let's talk about pH balance.
pH, for your system, you need to have your pH between a 5 and a 6.
Ah, okay.
And that way, because when your system's running, you don't want your pH to be out of balance. even if you have those nutrients that your plants need, if your pH is off, then your plants will lock out. And even if you have those nutrients they need, they will not grow. You'll have more issues with your plants. You have to have that perfect pH for the roots to actually uptake the nutrients and continue to grow.
Wow, so between 5 and 6?
Between 5 and 6.
Interesting, okay. Now what about sunlight though? Because we need those plants to grow, right?
Absolutely.
We need some sunlight.
Sunlight, you basically have to mimic the sunlight.
Okay.
I mean,
yeah.
Because if you're actually having your hydroponic system indoors,
sure.
Just like you guys teach us in the Master Gardener class, you know, you want to have your sunlight closer so you won't have your plants tall and stringly.
Right. That's
you
right.
know,
That's
so
right.
they won't die off. So you have to have your certain amount of hours, depending on what you're growing, your
sure.
lettuces, your strawberries, your tomatoes. You have to have those same amount of hours of sunlight that they need outdoors.
Okay.
So you can actually control that indoors with your grow lights.
Well, somebody learned something in the Master Gardener class.
Yeah,
how about
I know.
That, Mr. Brown? What about that? Now, what about preventative maintenance?
Okay. Preventative maintenance, for most of your hydroponic kits, you want to actually dump the solutions every week so you won't have too much of a salt buildup.
Okay.
Because your plants could be taking one nutrient more than another.
Right.
And so that means that you have excess of that nutrient that's not being used. And if you keep on putting more nutrient solutions in, then it'll be too much of one nutrient
that
could
sense.
Kill off your plants.
Okay.
So it's recommended each week that you actually dump it out and start over with fresh water with the perfect pH each week. And aeroponics is a continuous loop system where you won't have to actually worry about that until after you harvest.
Wow. Hmm. That's pretty good, huh? So you clean the system out.
Clean the system out.
Each week.
Each week. And refill it up with fresh water.
Fresh water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, what do you use to clean the system, though? I mean,
you actually don't. You just have to dump it out.
And that's it?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Just flush it
just
real
flush
good
it out.
And put fresh water in there.
Wow. Okay. What about yields? You mentioned a little bit about yields.
Yields, you'll have more consistent yields.
Okay.
Because you get to control the temperature, you get to control the sunlight, so you can basically speed up the yields, and also the conditions will be better. For example, strawberries, you won't have those outside in the elements.
Right.
So you're gonna have perfectly looking strawberries because there's nothing in there to damage them.
Now, are there certain vegetables that work better in a hydroponic system than others that you
Absolutely.
Would recommend?
Okay. I would recommend your loose leaf lettuces. That's something that's going to be a quick turnaround. Mm-hmm. I would not recommend anything that grows underground. You cannot
do your radishes.
You can't do your potatoes. Right. But anything that's going to grow above ground, you can actually do. Tomatoes, you can do your peppers. But your peppers may not taste like peppers. You probably won't have the heat.
Right,
because
sure.
you're not going to be able to dry out and get the heat into the peppers.
Hmm.
So.
Okay, something to think about. All right. Devin want to ask you about this. So what about any disease problems or any insect pest problems that may occur?
Hydroponics is just the same. You can actually have those same diseases that you have outdoors, but you can control those. For example, you're not going to have your moisture on your plants because your leaves are not getting wet.
Right.
And so a lot of times if it's not, it's air control that'll help you out with your hydroponic system.
Okay.
Circulation of air keeps your plants stronger.
Right.
So you want to have some type of fan system for circulation inside.
Okay. Hmm. Wow. Stephan, appreciate that, man. That's good stuff.
I have no problem.
No. Thank you much.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.